Today we'll be discussing about the synchronous machine, which is one of the machines of electrical machines. And as the name suggests, that a synchronous machine is a machine which runs actually on the synchronous speed. How? We'll just see that how the synchronous machine works on a synchronous speed. We have already seen in induction machine and DC machine that their principles are quite different, and DC machines have a different principle of working, and whereas induction machine have a different principle of working, and the synchronous machine too have a principle of working, but that too is different from other two which we have discussed earlier. In the synchronous machine, the synchronous machine is a doubly excited machine. First of all, doubly excited means the stator is supplied by some other source, and this rotor or the field, which is supplied by some other source. So in the previous sessions, in the DC machine sessions and the induction machine sessions, we have already said that the stator, which is having the field coils, and the rotor is having the armature coils. We have kept a discussion on that, but here the field coils are on the rotor part and the armature is on the stator part. Starting with the induction machine, that in an induction machine we have seen that there is a force, there is a speed, relative speed between the magnetic field and the rotor. So the motor starts. Here something is different which we will see. First of all, starting with the synchronous machine, it is actually the machine which works on the magnetic attraction of the unlike poles. What is that? We'll see. If I have a machine, synchronous machine, suppose it is having poles. Suppose right now I'm taking only two poles. This is my north pole and this is my south pole. Just for my consideration, I'm not taking the pole pitch, I'm not taking the pole shoe, and just to understand how my machine works actually. As I said, that it works on the principle of magnetic attraction between two unlike poles. So if these are north south, so this will be south and north. So in this machine, what exactly happens, that since there are different set of poles, north south, north and south, they are in such a direction that every time, whenever this becomes north, 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 this becomes north, 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 and at that time this will be stationary and it will be magnetically coupled, it will be magnetically blocked in that, and this north pole, when this pole becomes north, and so it gets attracted to this. Then when this becomes north, it gets attracted to this, then this, then this, then this, then I get a continuous motion in one direction, such that the speed of the rotation of my rotor is the synchronous speed, which we have already discussed, that ns is equals to 120 f by p. So there is one question arises over here, that we understand that very basic thing which we have understood in induction machine also, that the three-phase rotating magnetic field is created in the synchronous machine also. Here, and the stator, the three-phase magnetic field is suppose created, and three-phase rotating magnetic field is rotated in a synchronous speed. So when the rotor gets locked in that, the motor also moves in the same direction of the rotation of the magnetic field, and it starts rotating in the speed of synchronism. So both are synchronized. One question which I was asking about was that how the this rotor is having south and north pole, or the north and south pole, how the north and south pole are created on this rotor. So for that, if I have a rotor in such a fashion, if I have a rotor of dumbbell shape and the rotor is bound by some coil, and these coils are coming out of the machine, and these coils are connected to a DC supply, then I can have a permanent south and north pole on this rotor, and I can have the rotor which is a magnet now, which will be getting magnetically locked with the stator, and it will rotate. So rather than having this DC supply over here, I can have one DC generator mounted on the shaft such that it supplies the current IF, which produces the flux phi to make this rotor a electromagnet. So if I have a DC generator here, which will be giving current IF, that is the field current which it will be giving, and this IF will be producing the flux, and this flux will be giving the south and north pole, alternate south and north pole, which is the permanent magnet right now, or which is an electromagnet, but these poles are permanent in nature. The south pole will remain here only, the north pole will remain here only. So this will make my arrangement simpler. Now coming to another thing, that when the motor is not running, when the machine is not running, what happens? Since the machine is not running and this DC generator is coupled to my shaft of this rotor only, so there is no EMF generated here, and since there is no EMF generated over here, no current IF will be generated, no current, no flux, no flux will be here, so no north and south pole. Although I am having a rotating magnetic field in the stator, but since my electromagnet is not there, so it will not get locked, and it will not, the motor will not run. So one very important thing about a synchronous machine, also synchronous motor, is that a synchronous motor is not a self-starting motor. There are some ways of starting the synchronous machine, we'll be discussing those, but before that we should understand that since the rotor of the synchronous motor is connected over here with a DC generator over here, which is actually coupled to the shaft of the motor only. So once the shaft of the motor moves, then the DC generator moves, then it produces a EMF, then it produces the current field IF, then it produces the flux, which produces the north and south pole. But here, since there is no movement of the rotor, then what happens? Since there is no movement of the rotor, so this shaft is not moving, so the DC generator will not be producing any electricity or any power or any EMF, and that will not be producing any current IF. And since there is no IF at that point, so no, this coil or this dumbbell shape, which is called the silent pole rotor, will not be called as the electromagnet. And since it will not be electromagnet, it will not be a north and south pole. So the motor will not run. So how to start this motor in that case? So first thing which we have understood till now is that a synchronous machine, synchronous motor, is not a self-starting motor. Apart from that, since it is not self-starting, there should be a way that the machine should run. So the starting of the machine, we'll start with the starting of the machine. starting the synchronous machine. For the synchronous motor, first of all, starting the synchronous motor, that is the three-phase synchronous machine we are talking about. So the first way would be, since we have seen that the rotor, these are my poles, and a rotor or dumbbell shape or the select pole type of rotor is there. A dumbbell shaped rotor is there, and which is actually fed from a generator, which is actually a DC generator. And this DC generator actually is giving a current IF in my field coils. But since again the field coils are the flux phi, only if the IF is there, IF will be coming only by EF, which is the DC generator output, and DC generator output will only come when the DC generator shaft will be moving, and the shaft will be only moving when the shaft of the same machine will be moving. But since it is not working, since this is the motor is at standstill, then there will not be any EMF, there will not be IF, there will not be the flux phi, and there will not be any movement in the synchronous machine. So synchronous machine are not self-starting. So I can have an arrangement such that I can have some damper windings over here, some damper windings which we have discussed in the synchronous machine also, in the induction machine also, the damper, why the damper windings are there. So in the synchronous machine, damper winding are provided. There are two reasons of providing of the damper winding. First is the for the starting of the machine. By damper windings, the starting of the synchronous machine is there. But how? Since the by having the damper windings, they are shorted, which we have already seen in the synchronous machine, that in the induction machine, in the induction machine, we have seen that the squirrel cage induction machine, in the squirrel cage induction machine, the rotor of the machine is having the end rings, and these here also the end damper windings are shorted one, such that when the current is in the three phase windings start flowing exactly in the same way that the induction machine does, we can repeat that if somebody would have forgotten that. If there is a three-phase rotating magnetic field, it passes through the air gap, it touches the rotor, which is right now not a dumbbell shaped rotor, which is it is all these damper windings. Now these damper windings are shorted, so the current starts flowing, and that current will try to build up a force as in the induction machine. So by damper winding, it is exactly the machine is started as an induction machine, and when it is almost at the synchronous speed, since we know that the induction machine almost moves at the synchronous speed with a slip, so there will be a slip between the synchronous speed of the machine in case of induction machine and the actual motor speed. So there will be a slip. So up to the synchronous, up to the verge of the synchronism, we energize this IF so that it will get magnetically coupled with the my synchronous machine, and synchronous machine or my synchronous motor start moving, motoring as a synchronous motor. So again, understanding this way, by damper winding, the machine is actually started as an induction machine, and when the induction, this induction machine picks up the speed up to the its normal speed, which is normal induction machine is having, which is slightly less than the synchronous speed by the slip. So at the time, at that time, the this machine is actually energized by this IF, and by flowing this IF, the these dumbbell shape becomes a magnet, and that gets magnetically locked into the synchronism, and that at that time the machine works as a synchronous machine, and it continue to work as a synchronous machine. The second way could be by AC motor. AC or DC motor. We can have AC or DC motor in coupled with the my synchronous motor, such that my synchronous motor is here and it is mechanically coupled. This synchronous motor is mechanically coupled to my another AC motor, which is normally can be induction, another induction motor, or DC motor, which can be a compound motor. By either of the two, when they are the my synchronous motor is mechanically coupled to any of the machines, either the AC machine or the DC machine, then this motor starts rotating, so the shaft of this also starts rotating, and in the same way this shaft is moving, so this synchronous machine rotor starts moving, and it's once it is almost the speed of the synchronous speed, at that time this rotor is get energized by IF, or we can say EF, and IF current flows in this, and flux is created that north and south pole, and at that time it gets magnetically coupled into the synchronism, and it gets magnetically blocked with the synchronous speed of the motor, and it attains the speed of synchronous speed, and my motor starts running in the synchronous speed. So this is another way of starting of my synchronous motor, that one is the damper winding, or by magnetically coupling the actual machine, actually synchronous machine, by either the DC motor, either by the AC motor.